these teams, and we're pushing very hard. I think the biggest headwind we have is that you have Democrats that don't want to see it happen, but I think they want to play, and the fans want to see it, and the players have a lot at stake, including possibly playing in the NFL. You have a lot of great players in that conference, and maybe we'll be very nicely surprised.
Not law and order, not mail-in voting. That is President Trump remaining hopeful for the Big Ten Conference and relaunching their football season. The president spoke after a phone call with Kevin Warren, that's the conference's commissioner, about how the conference could get the season up and running as soon as possible. In a tweet, the president's comments came after that phone call with Kevin. And in a tweet, he says this. He's very productive, had a very productive conversation with Kevin Warren, the commissioner of the Big Ten Conference, about immediately starting up the Big Ten football would be great for everyone, players, fans, country. And there it is on the one-yard line. Joining us to discuss now is Tom Anderson, NLPC Government Integrity Project Director. Good to see you, sir. Talk to me about this, because we know on August 11th, the conference delayed their season, but now the Big Ten sources are saying nothing has changed at all. Medical question has to be answered before we can even think about getting this back. Can fans be hopeful about this? Because there's a disconnect between what the president has said with his talks with Kevin Warren and then obviously what sources inside the Big Ten are saying right now.
Look, I can tell you right now, there will be Big Ten football this year, period. It's going to happen. It's going to happen because there are two issues that the Big Ten has been dealing with, and they're going to get over both, but the two issues are real simple. Starting the football season is easy. You can start it. The problem is keeping it going. Making sure you don't have an athlete die on the field is a big issue. So they were dealing with that at first. One of the big things that came from that issue was a second issue, an illness called myocarditis. That's caused by inflammation to the heart, and you can suddenly die from that if you're an athlete, and COVID-19 causes it. I think there are about 12 athletes that have gotten myocarditis since camp has started. So the issue with that has actually been wiped away. They brought in, the Big 12 brought in the Mayo Clinic's head cardiologist. His name is Michael Ackerman. He's an expert on myocarditis, and he said that for young athletes, they're okay. What you have to be able to do, though, is make sure that they have a squeaky clean heart exam if they contract COVID-19.
Yeah.
So, which they're going to take care of. So at the end of the day, there will be some Big Ten football. It may not start when the other leagues are starting,
sure,
but they're going to have it.
I know a lot of folks are, sports fans are excited to hear what you just had to say. I don't have much time with you. I want to ask you, because I have you here, your organization, the National Legal and Policy Center, running social media ads here, basically focusing on LeBron James and the NBA. Talk to me about that. What's going on with that and why the focus on that?
Well, we're running ads on that because, of course, of the environment we're in right now. We're in an environment where human rights are at the top of the list across the board here in our country and internationally. We've got protests everywhere when it comes to human rights. China's a huge issue, especially when it comes to sports and the NBA. We had the big issue with Daryl Morey, the general manager of the Houston Rockets, who was basically slammed by LeBron James. LeBron James has been silent on all of this. We feel like his silence is due to the money he's making, not only through the NBA, but also through Nike. And China, you know, is making shoes. You know, there are factories in China making LeBron shoes. Some of these factories are using slave labor, apparently, to some human rights groups. And so we're trying to bring attention to this because we feel like LeBron's silence on this is helping the Chinese regime continue to crack down on the Uyghurs. We feel like his silence is helping them hurt the freedom fighters in Hong Kong. And so, you know, LeBron in the past said that he wasn't opposed to Daryl Morey's tweet, the content of the tweet. What he was upset about, and I'll quote, he said, let me clear up the confusion. I do not believe there was any consideration for the consequences and ramifications of the tweet. I'm not discussing the substance. Others can talk about that. So he was upset that Daryl Morey didn't consider the consequences of the tweet. What we're saying to LeBron James is, you are not considering the consequences of your silence.
Yeah.
And those consequences are much worse than the consequences of Daryl Morey's tweet.
Well,
that's what we're bringing attention to.
He has not been silent about the president and how he feels about that here in the States. That, what a great point that you bring up there. That is Tom Anderson. Tom, good to see you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Take care.
You too. Coming up, we